السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. ربي زدني علما، اللهم فقهنا في الدين، آمين يا رب العالمين. Lesson number 15. Particle and types of particles. حرف وأقسام الحروف. الحمد لله. We have completed ism and today we are going to learn about particle, harf. But before starting a new lesson, let's revise through the previous lessons. We hope that all of you have memorized that every single term that we speak out from our mouth is called lafz word. Meaningful word is called kalima and meaningless word is called muhmal. We haven't studied about muhmal because it's meaningless and there's no need to study about meaningless things or words. Although the further two types of kalima are singular kalima, mufrad, and compound kalima, murakkab kalima. Inshallah, we will learn about compound words in detail after completing particles and verbs. Singular word mufrad kalima is divided into three categories: ism, verb, and particle. Noun, verb, and particle. For understanding clearly about this combination, let us see the graph form of singular kalima. Word or lafz is divided into two. Number one, kalima, meaningful word, and number two, muhmal, meaningless word. The kalima is further divided into number one, mufrad kalima, singular word, and number two, murakkab kalima, compound word. The mufrad kalima, singular word, is further divided into noun, ism, verb, fi'l, and particle, harf. Before understanding the particle thoroughly, first let's revise the previously studied details about particle. In the previous lesson, we have learned that alphabets, huruf al-tahajji, are named as huruf al-hija in Arabic. There are 28 letters in al-hija, from which three letters alif, waw, and ya are named vowels, huruf illat, and other huruf al-hija are called consonants, huruf al-sahih. Hamzatul wasal, or the connecting alif. This is an alif which basically doesn't belong to any word but is just an additional letter which comes at the beginning of a word and usable only when we want to read a word separately. Otherwise, in fluent reading, we don't prefer to read this alif. For example, huwallah, Allah is he. In this example, alif is written as hamzatul wasal. Alif mamduda. This is an alif which contains mad on it. For example, as-sama'u, the sky. The alif after mim is an alif mamduda. Similarly, alif maqsura is an alif which is placed on the top of ya in the form of small alif. For example, as in the word kubra, the alif on the top of yam. We also studied that alif is always free from signs or harakat and jazm alamat sukun. On the other hand, hamza is a letter which defines itself with harakat and jazm and it is read in all conditions. Hamza is also named as hamzatul wasal or hamzatul qata'i. Now let's start learning about particle, harf in detail. Particle, harf. The meaning of particle is side or corner. Particle is free from verb tense, fi'l. Particle is only used for joining two verbs, two nouns, or for joining a noun with a verb. Although particles have their own meanings, but the listener can only understand when verbs or nouns come together with particles. They depend upon the verb and the noun for understanding their complete meaning. Identification of particles. Particles are identified by the fact that the below given signs for noun and verb are not found in them. Signs to identify the verb and noun. First, let's see the signs for identifying the noun that are not found in the particle. The first one is presence of al at the beginning of the word written as alif lam. The second, ending letter of the word kalima contains tanween. The third, presence of the addressing or the calling letter harf-e-nida before the word. the presence of Taya Marbuta at the end of the word. Number 5, the word belongs to Mudaf possessive, Naat, Musaghar, diminished, Mansub, proper adjective, Tathniya, dual, Jama, plural. We have already studied them in lesson number 6. Hence, the identity of particle is that none of the symbols or conditions of ism are available in it. Now, let's look at those signs of the verbs that are not present in particles. Number 1, presence of qad before the word or kalima. Number 2, presence of seen before kalima. Number 3, presence of saufa before the kalima. Number 4, presence of ta'i sakina at the end of kalima. Number 5, the last letter of the word has ta'i fa'il, ta fatha, ta kasra, and ta dhamma, ta tu ti, showing the attached pronoun dhamir muttasil. Number 6, the word is in a commanding tense, kalima amr. Number 7, negative kalima or kalima nahi, meaning a negative word or command is present. Number 8, at the beginning of the word, the letters atayin or yatani is present. If at the beginning of a word, huruf jazim, assertive characters, means the letter which gives jazm to a word, or huruf nasib, sharp characters, is there in sentence, then this will be a verb. Number 10, if at the end of kalima stressful noun, noon taqid sakhila, meaning noon mushaddad, or noon khafifa, meaning noon sakin, silent noun is written, then this will be a verb. This has been explained in lesson 6, named identification of noun, verb and character or particle. I recommend you to rewatch lesson 6 to clarify today's lesson. Like the nouns, we will understand the types of particles also in three ways. There are three categories of particles. They are, number 1, division of particle according to lam tarif, the introductory lam, alif lam. Number 2, division of particles according to vowels letters, that is huruf illa. And number 3, division of particles according to certain factors or agents, awamil. For understanding the complete usage of particles, please note down a few characteristics of particles. Number 1, all particles are non-changeable, mabni, meaning the movements or signs harakat of their end letters never change. Number 2, particles don't have different forms sere like the different forms of verb and noun in Arabic. Number 3, particles don't have the conjugations gardan like the verb and noun except for laysa and kana, because these are incomplete verbs afaal naqisa. Number 4, in particles there are no common noun isma nakira and proper noun isma ma'rifa as seen in the nouns. Number 5, some of the particles make changes in i'rab of verb and some do changes in the i'rab of noun. Number 6, particles sometimes come at the beginning of sentence before mubtada and sometimes seen at the end of the sentence. Number 7, particles can come separately in a sentence and can also come together with noun, pronoun and verb. For example, at-tilmidhu fil madrasati. The student is in the school. In this example, fi is a particle that comes separately and which combines two nouns, at-tilmiz and al-madrasa. The second example is dhahabtu bil kitabi. I went with the book. In this example, particle b has joined together the verb dhahabtu with the noun al-kitab and the particle comes along with the noun. The third example is dhahabtu min al-madinati ila al-makkah. I went to Makkah from Medina. In this example, the particle min connects the verb zahabtu with a noun al-Madina and the particle ila connects the noun al-Madina with another noun al-Makkah. Let's see the structure of particles for understanding it more clearly. Let's understand the division of a particle now. Division of particles. They are divided into three, the first one based upon lam-e-tarif al, according to the al defining article lam-e-tarif al. The second one is according to the vowels, huruf Allah. And the third one is according to the factors or agents, awamil. According to lam ta'rif, it is further divided into two, sun letters, huruf shamsi, and moon letters, huruf qamari, based on the lam ta'rif. Based on the huruf illah, they are divided into vowels, huruf illah, and consonants, huruf sahih. Based on the awamil or agents, they are divided into huruf amil and huruf ghair amil. The first category of particle is according to lam ta'rif, al. Lam ta'rif is further divided into two parts. Sun letters, huruf shamsi, and moon letters, huruf qamari. Both of them begin with lam ta'rif, that is with al. Now we are going to compare both of them. Huruf shamsi, sun letters, these particles are 14 in number and they are ta, tha, dal, dhal, ra, za, seen, sheen, swad, dod, ta, dha, lam, noon. The moon letters, huruf qamari, these letters are also 14 in number and they are alif, ba, jim, ha, kha, ayn, ghain, fa, qaf, kaf, mim, waw, ha, ya. For remembering these letters, the Urdu sentence haq ka khauf ajab gham hai can be memorized. You will find all the 14 letters in this sentence. The next comparison is the huruf shamsi. Lam ta'rif al is only in written form. While reading, it's a silent letter. For example, if I have al plus shamsun, alif lam al plus shamsun, the word will be read as ash-shamsu, ash-shamsu. The lam will be, the lam is not read. It means if after al any letter comes after from huruf shamsiya, then lam will change in the form of huruf shamsi and idgham will occur. Whereas in huruf khamari, al can be both read and written. For example, al plus qamarun, al qamaru. The lam is read in this case, al qamaru. The letter that comes after al contains stress, that is tajdeed. In huruf shamsi, the letter comes with tajdeed. Whereas in huruf qamari, the letter that comes after al doesn't carry stress or tajdeed. Both the words in huruf shamsi and huruf qamari begin with alif lam al. In huruf shamsi, if al comes before the sun letters, then in fluency, while combining it with the previous word, this al will be dropped and its sound will not be pronounced. But in huruf qamari, if al comes before huruf qamari moon letters, then while reading in a flow, the alif of al will be dropped and only lam will be pronounced with the previous letter. Example, Rabbul Alameen. Let's look at this at some of the examples of huruf shamsi and huruf qamari. Examples of huruf shamsi: At-Tariq, As-Sabur, Ar-Rashid, An-Nur, An-Nafi', Ar-Rauf, Al-Thawab, Al-Zahir, Al-Shahid, Al-Latif, Al-Shakur. The lam is not pronounced in any of these words. Let's look at the examples of huruf al-qamari. Al-Ghafoor, Al-Warithu, Al-Baqiyu, Al-Badi'u, Al-Hadiyu, Al-Mani'u, Al-Mughni, Al-Ghaniyu, Al-Jami'u, Al-Muqsitu, Al-Afuwu. So we see that the lam is pronounced in these words. Alhamdulillah. Today we have read about particles from the three types of singular word, mufrad kalima, noun, verb and particles. We have also read that the particles are further divided into three. Number one, division of particles based on lam ta'rif, introductory lam, al. Number 2, division of particles based on the vowels, huruf illa. And number 3, division of particles based on factors or agents, awamil. Today we have completed the division of particles based on lam ta'rif. Inshallah, we will study about the division of particles based on vowels in detail in our next class.
Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.